Fine, no issues. Now I am starting the quiz. Yes. Fine, so first question is in front of you, students. Okay, just now someone has joined. An aluminium atom has a nucleon number 27 and proton number 13. How many neutrons does this aluminium atom contain? You know, you have only 20 seconds left.
So the text is still kind of small.
Okay, fine. Over. So now.
Yes, sir. Over. Thank you.
Okay, one minute. I'll close this. So, okay. Answer is B, because neutrons are nothing but mass number minus atomic number. Is it clear? Any doubt? Neutrons are mass number minus atomic number. Mass is 27. Atomic number is 13. 27 minus 13 is 14. Moving to next question.
Jayant, please mute.
Okay, one. Fine. Who is this metal? Tell me name. Tell me your name.
Sir, so I think if you click the metal, so just click it, then the name will come. No, sir, so you have to click metal.
It's already the default name.
Yes, sir. The name will take it into its default name, sir.
Okay, fine. So, my next question. Next question is this. An atom of element 2 contains electron, proton.
Sir, what is yttrium?
Yes, that is one atom.
Wait, that's... Oh.
Yttrium is an element.
It's an element, bro.
Okay, over. So, 42 students are right in this question. We'll see how to do. Atoms 19, proton, electron, neutron. You know, you need to remember that atomic number 19 is for potassium. You should remember this. So electron is proton and neutron are 20. If they only give the proton number also, you could have guessed it right. It is like potassium only. Calcium has atomic number 20, like that. Okay, you are expected to know till atomic number 20. You are expected to know till 20. So remember till atomic number 20. Okay? Any doubt? Okay, next question. Next question. Okay. Answer is potassium. Atomic number 19 is potassium. You have 1 minute for this question. Okay. Yes, I know the full periodic table, but I know you people remember by the song. Okay, but I don't remember the song. What happened?
So it's time in 3 seconds.
Okay, fine. So now, I think it times up, and the result is, oh, most of you have answered it right, but many of you are wrong also. Fine. So answer for this question is A. Not a metal. Not a metal means C. 18 electron, 18 proton. It is nothing but argon. Argon is 18 electron, 18 proton. So that's a fine. Now if you see 19 electron, 19 proton is potassium. This is also potassium. 20 is calcium. So calcium, potassium, potassium. Answer is argon only. Any doubt? Any doubt? No doubt? Fine. I am moving to next question. Students, why you... 15 students have answered, not just 15. 24 and 7. Oh my god. Almost 50% students have answered it wrong. I don't know for what reason. Okay. Moving to the next question. Now, this is the fourth question. Which statement about atoms is correct? Which statement about atoms is correct? Which statement about atom is correct? Fine. So I think it times up now. No, still you have time. Code is, okay, 1 minute. Code is 692585. Okay, students, we'll see the result now. Last 1 second, and the answer is, okay, we'll see how many of you have answered it right. Oh, most of you have answered it right only. Very easy. Fine. So the question is, atoms which are correct, protons are positively charged. Nucleons number is number of neutrons. No. Neutrons are negatively charged. No. Atoms contain proton and electron in the nucleus. Yes. No, which is correct. So this is also wrong. Proton and electron in nucleus. No. Okay, fine. Could I move to next question? Neutron is not negatively charged. Nucleons is number of neutron. No. Yes, next question. 1 minute. 1 minute, 1 minute. Fine. So, yes, 1 minute. I'll move to next question. So, next question is this. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Sir, what is this? What? Grace, what happened? Grahesh, what happened? Okay, fine.
So who is metal?
Okay, please students, who is metal? Please tell me. Metal? You are not going to rebel? Okay, fine. We'll see something. Okay, fine. Wait for one more, two questions. Don't worry.
So you can before just kick the person out.
Before last question, I will definitely kick him out. Okay? So next. Okay, fine. So, but he or she can tell me the name. Okay, next question. Don't get worried about that. I will definitely, you will get the fair results. Okay. Here, question is, font is small. Now you can see the, which diagram correctly shows the ion present in the compound potassium chloride? Which diagram correctly shows the ion present in compound potassium chloride? Yes. Potassium chloride. Why you don't know? Think. Fine. I think your time's up. No, still you have 3 seconds left. Okay. So answer for this question is So C is the answer. No problem. Okay, we'll see how to solve this question. Very easy question. Potassium chloride, if I ask you formula, you all will write sir KF. Yes or no? First tell me, formula is KF or not? Yes? Okay. Now KF is there. You know, this is metal. This is non-metal. All of you know this thing. Nothing new in that. Metal lose electron. That's why it gains positive charge. Non-metal gains electron. That's why it gets negative charge. In other words, whenever potassium loses electron, it gets positive charge like this. Whenever fluorine gains electron, it gets negative charge like this. Any doubt? 1 minute. What you people are discussing 4x4 and all. Please tell me, do you have any doubt? No doubts? Okay, fine. Potassium is losing one electron. If you see, potassium atomic number is 19. 19 atomic number means if you see the electronic configuration, 2, 8, 8, 1. Yes or no? 2, 8, 8, 1 is the electronic configuration. Yes, by satisfying the octet, 2, 8, 8, 1. Now, if you go for the fluorine, atomic number 9, 2, because total is 9, so 2, 7. Total is 2, 7. Now, if there is a plus, K plus means removal of electron. If I remove the electron, this electron will be removed. So, new configuration, so K plus configuration is nothing but 2, 8, 8. So, see where you have the 2, 8, 8. Now, what is the fluorine? Fluoride ion? 2, because it is gaining electron. So, this 7 become 8. 2, 8. Now, see which is the configuration. First shell has 2, then 8, then 8. So, it seems like 2, 8, 3 shells should be there in potassium. Yes, it seems 3 shells. So, 2, 8, 8. It seems correct. It also seems correct. C and D seems correct for potassium. If you go for the fluoride, 2, 8. 2, 8 seems correct. Here, 1 minute. How come both are correct? Just a minute.
Both are the same, C and D.
Both are correct, yes?
Sir, F is showing plus.
Sir, D is showing K minus.
Oh, sorry. They have shown plus. Very good. Oh.
Sir,
answer is wrong. Answer is C because it is minus here. Is it clear to all of you? Answer is C. Yes.
Sir, can you please change it in Menti? Some of us would have marked C.
Okay, what is the answer there? It is C only.
Dude, C is correct.
It's D.
C is correct.
So C is only correct.
Yes. I'm moving to next question. Any doubt? Yes. Fine. Okay. Just give me 1 second. I'll remove this. Fine. We are moving to next question. You can see your... Okay, fine. Very good, Gargi. Anuya. Okay, I don't know how to pronounce. ELMO. You please help me in that. Okay. So, next question is this. If you face any issue, you can refer this. What do the nuclei 1H1 hydrogen atom contains? You have only 30 seconds to answer this. Okay, fine. I think it time's up, yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, answer for this question is nuclei 1, 1. You know, whenever you have any element, This is the thing which you write here is mass number. I told you in class also. This is mass number, and the thing which you write here is the atomic number. Is the atomic number or number of proton or number of proton? Number of proton. Now if you see 1, 1, proton is 1, mass number is 1. Mass is nothing but neutron plus proton. Neutron plus proton is mass. So if you add these two, you will find that there is no neutron because mass is also 1. So answer is proton only. Any doubt? No doubt. Could I move to next one?
Sir, is it atomic number number of electrons?
No, atomic number is number of electrons only when there is a neutral atom. In case of neutral atom, atomic number is equal to number of electrons. Neutral atom, electron and proton are same. Or atomic number is same. Electron, proton and atomic number, all three are same. In a neutral atom. But if you don't have the neutral atom, if you don't have the neutral atom, let's take an example. If I say sodium plus, not 12. Atomic number is 11. Very good. Okay. Proton is
11.
But what are number of electrons? Electrons are? Because I've written Na plus. Okay, you people are going wrong here. I have written Na plus, not Na.
Yes,
Na has 11 electrons.
Sir, 12.
No, Na plus. Plus means it has lost the electron.
Negative.
When you lose, when something loses negative charge, then only it will get positive charge. So it has lost one electron, so total number of electrons are 10. Understood? So atomic number and electrons are not always same. Am I clear? Could I move to next
one? Yes, sir.
I'm erasing all these things. Okay, fine. So, next question. Oh, results are very disappointing. Fine. We'll see who is leading now. So, very good. Gargi and Elmo. Or Anulia, MTS, INR. Very good. Fine, next question. You can refer this. If you still face any issue, please let me know. You know, very easy questions. Just we are playing around this neutron, electron, proton, ion, isotope, isobar, isotone. That's it. I can't even see why, Gargi. I think it's quite visible to all of you. If any other has facing any issue, please let me know. Okay. Could I? 1 minute.
How can the number of nucleons be lesser than the number of protons?
So what's the correct answer?
So time's up.
Okay, time's up. Now see, question is, the table shows the nucleon number.
Nucleon number be lesser than the number of neutrons?
Okay, just a minute.
Yes, that's why even I didn't know.
The table shows nucleon number and number of neutrons in one atom.
Yes, sir, even I didn't understand, sir.
Okay, 1 minute. Table shows the nucleon number and the number of neutrons in one atom of isotope WXYZ. Okay, isotopes are given. Nucleon number and number of neutron they have given. Which statement about WXYZ is correct? So, if you see...
Sir, can you delete the question?
Okay.
So, the nucleon number is only 3, 3, 3 and 4. So, number of neutrons is 18, 20, 20 and 22.
Okay, fine. This should be atomic number.
Are you writing something?
Yes.
I can't see anything.
this should be atomic number.
So can you redo the question without explaining it so then we can actually do it, sir?
Okay, if the atomic number is given to you, one minute. Nucleon number they have given 333. Which statement about WXYZ? X and Y are isotope. X and Y are isotope. 1 minute.
So can we redo the question, sir?
Why?
Because it's marked wrong and it's confusing, so then at least
W and X are isotope of same element.
Continue, this is fine.
Okay, fine. 1 minute. Later
that's
I will delete
after, for me.
Okay, after finishing this, I will delete this. Okay, once we'll finish all the quiz, then I will delete it. Fine? Okay,
yes.
Next question. No need to delete it.
So, I will delete this question later. Next question. What happened? No, I will not forget. You tell me before. Okay, now next question. 1 minute. So, this is the next question.
So the screen is black for me.
Okay, I don't think that it's black for all of you because I am also seeing the screen in my phone. So I think it's visible. Okay, anyone else facing any issue, please let me know. In this. Okay, fine. Please refresh it. Which element has atomic structure this? Okay, fine. So I need to delete question number 7. Okay, I will delete it. Okay.
So time up.
Answer is B, and many of you have answered it wrong. See if you want to see the result. Maximum of you have done it wrong by more than 50%. Fine, I'll tell you how to do this. You know, electronic configuration, we will write it. Very easy question. Number of electrons given. In first shell, there are 2 electrons. In second shell, this is first shell. Second shell, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 8. 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 electrons. Calculate, total is 15. 15 is nothing but phosphorus. Atomic number 15 is phosphorus. Why you people have made mistake, I don't know. Okay, tell me if anyone has any doubt. Please ask students if you have any doubt. Do you have any doubt? Yes or no? No doubt, sure? It's very easy question, I guess.
Sir, I couldn't see it because of the blank screen. That's why I had to mark it.
Oh, okay, but still, how many? Instead of counting elements, I counted number of letters in the. Oh my God, Monisha, what you are doing? Okay, fine. You know, if someone has gone through the using the 16 neutron, so he or she must have answered C. But neutrons are not same as the number of proton. So that's why I don't take 16. Neutrons may be different. Okay, next.
How many people are right, sir?
Okay, wait. I'll show you the result. This is the C, 17 students, second most selected answer. So use your brain, student. And Anuya is leading. Very good, Anuya. Fine. Next question. This is the next question. A relative atomic mass of chlorine is 35.5. When calculating relative atomic mass, which particle is the mass of chlorine atom compared to? 30 seconds. Okay.
So time.
Okay, fine. Okay, answer is C12. I told you all the atoms are compared with the C12, an atom of C12. That is a reference. This atom is reference. Okay, next question. I think all of you have answered it right.
Can you go back? It's written the relative mass is
35.5. Yes.
Isn't 35.5, how is, sir, when we put in the formula, it will be wrong.
No. When you put into formula, see, relative atomic mass is always 35. You know that how you got 35 and 37? Because it is, your 35.5 is obtained by the two isotopes, Cl35 and Cl37. This Cl35 and Cl37 are going to decide that, actually this is 75% and this is 25% in nature. That's why you get relative atomic mass is 35.5. But this 35 and 37 are nothing but with respect to C12. Understood?
Okay, sir.
Okay, what's the formula? Formula for calculating 35.5 is... Okay. Anyone else who has any doubt in this? Any doubt? Okay, what's the formula? Dhruv, the formula will be... Okay, relative atomic mass of any element is mass of atom divided by 1 by 12th mass of C12 isotope. This is the formula. Okay, which is relative atomic mass is always with respect to C12. Could I move to next question? If all of you understood this, one minute. Students, please don't try.
Sir, R&R haven't learned this.
Okay, R&R haven't learned this. R&R students, you can't say this thing. I have told you in class. Don't say that you have not learned. I told you mass of an atom is always with respect to C12. Yes or no? R&R students?
No, sir.
We haven't learned.
No, sir.
I remember I told you in the class fine. Then... Nepal, I remember, Nepal students know, RNR also, I think. No problem, there are, but you should remember this, okay? I think in last year you must have had this question like this. From now onwards, you can remember.
So can you just calculate it, sir?
Okay, fine. See, this 35.5 is not going, you are not going to find this 35.5 by this formula. By this formula, you will get the chlorine mass as 35 and 37. Or these are the experimental data. Using this formula, you got the 35 and 37. What does this mean? Chlorine isotope that is having a 35 mass is 35 times heavier than 1 by 12th part of C12.
Can you at least calculate the 1 by 12th part of C12? What does that mean? Like calculate
1 by 12th part of C12 is nothing but C12 is 12 AMU. C12 is 12 AMU. This is experimental value. When C12 mass is 12 AMU, what is the 1 by 12th part of C12? It is 1 AMU. Now it is the denominator is nothing but 1.
Isn't the hydrogen atom 1 AMU?
Yes, hydrogen atom is 1 AMU. So this denominator is nothing but 1 AMU. But you don't define with respect to hydrogen. You define with respect to carbon 12. Earlier people took hydrogen as a reference. But I told you in class that there are some problems with hydrogen. It was not giving you whole number ratio for all the atoms. That's why people deleted this. So 1 AMU is the denominator. Now when the denominator is 1 AMU, I say relative atomic mass of sulfur is 32. What does this mean? Mass of sulfur atom using this equation. Using which equation? This equation. If relative atomic mass is 32, it is observed. By mass spectrometry, we found that relative atomic mass of sulfur is 32. Using mass spectrometry. Okay, so mass of sulfur is nothing but how much? 32 into 1 AMU. So mass of sulfur atom is nothing but 32 AMU. Is it clear? All the masses are defined like this. Hey, what you people have started discussing, I love mango and all. I will throw you out those who are discussing anything else. Okay, is it clear, students?
Yes, sir.
RNR students, all?
Yes, sir.
Is it fine? Yeah. Okay, fine. Next question. Please remind me on after 15th question, I will change the, I will delete the 7th one. Just remind me after 15th question. Okay? Fine. Next question. Bharat. Okay, Bharat. So, next question is this. Atom contains electron, neutron and proton. What is the definition of nucleon number? 30 seconds. At least in this question, I want that a single line in the entire chart. At least show, I have never seen a single line in chemistry. Never. Never ever. So,
sir, time's up.
Okay, fine.
So let's what do you mean single line?
Oh my god, still many students have made mistakes. Okay, no problem. So, atoms contain electron, proton, neutron. What is the definition of nucleon number? Nucleon is nothing but neutron plus proton in any atom. That is the nucleon. And this nucleon number is nothing but mass number also. That is nothing but mass number. So, number of neutron in nucleus of an atom, number of proton in nucleus, total number of neutron and proton. See, is that so? Dev, Gandhar, do you want me to remove you? Okay, fine. I'm moving to the next question.
Yeah, what do I do?
Okay, no problem. I heard some voice, that's why I, and you were unmuted. Okay. Oh, Dhruv was there. Sorry, Gandhar. Dhruv, please don't do. Now, we are going to next question. Moving to next one. So, this time, all of you got good marks. So, who is leading? Anuya, NPS, INR is leading. Good, Anuya.
Sir, I didn't do anything.
Okay, next question. The diagram shows the atomic number of an element X. What is X? This time, please don't make mistake. That's true. This is easy question. Okay.
Sir, I think Menti is glitching.
Sir, it kicked me out of the quiz.
Sir, it kicked me out of the quiz and then got me back and it's his correct answer.
And then sir,
now it can get it. Sir, it's telling I couldn't answer in time.
Yeah, it's saying
me it's fine, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, I think I'm able to see the question in my mobile.
So, basically, so, whoever did it, so when that when the quiz stopped working, whoever could didn't answer before that, they couldn't vote in time. So,
okay, fine.
So, time up.
Okay, time up. So, question is very easy. The diagram shows the structure and they have asked you the atomic, what is the X, element X. So, these are the shells given to you. Now, proton, electron, neutron, X is, there are, if you see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 electrons. 4 electrons is nothing but hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium. So, 1 electron, 2 electron, 3 electron, 4 electron. This is one way of doing. If anyone knows the configuration also, 2,2 is the configuration of beryllium. Fine. Just one question I want to ask. What is the configuration of aluminium? What is the configuration of aluminium? Anyone? Okay, atomic number of aluminium?
7 is the atomic number, 25
is the configuration. No, wrong.
So, aluminium number is 13.
So, 283.
Atomic number is 13, my dear.
283, sir. 283, sir.
So configuration is 2, comma, because 13, 8 and 8. Okay, there are, if some student is facing any issue in writing the configuration, I will help you in one line. If in one cell, okay, maximum number of electron in any shell, maximum number of electron in any shell, I think few students are facing issue, maximum number of electron in any shell is nothing but 2n square. So if I ask you one first shell, how many electrons could be accommodated? That is 2 into 1 square. That is 2. How many electrons are there in the second shell? This is first shell. And this is the second shell. Second shell. How many electrons you can put it here? 2, 2 square. 2, 2 square is 8. Now, if last question I am going to ask, what is the configuration of argon? What is the configuration of argon? No, I am not asking you atomic number. Argon configuration. Argon configuration. Because atomic number is 18, maximum number of electrons in first shell is 2. Maximum number of electron in second shell could be 8. But still you have 10 electrons. You have spilled the 10 electrons. What about the next 8? Next 8 will come in this. Okay. Now I know that most of you are going to make mistake in the next question. What is the atomic, what is the configuration of calcium? What is the configuration of calcium? I know most of you are going to make mistake.
2882.
Okay, there are two options. 2882 or 2810.
2882.
No one is with me, like I'm saying 2810.
So it's 2882.
Yes, very good. 2882. Maximum electron in the last shell can't exceed than 8. Okay? In a configuration. Just remember this. We will discuss it in detail in some chapter. As of now, maximum electron.
So we learned this last year.
Okay, I am talking about CBSE students.
So we are CBSE.
So,
like
NBS, CBSE.
NBS, INR, we learned it last year.
Okay, then all CBSE, all...
So,
CBSE
but then we do follow
we
NCRT.
We do follow
NCRT.
Last year, we didn't follow NCRT, Ahan.
We had ICSE.
Okay, 1 minute. INR students, do you know this? Calcium configuration,
yes, sir.
INR?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes.
That is good.
20
okay,
configuration,
okay.
Sir.
Okay, you just need till 20 only in class 9th also, but I will teach you more. In my next quiz, I will take more than 20 also. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. Okay, so this time also I didn't get a single line. We'll see the results first. Okay, Anuya is still on the first position and now Anush is coming. Okay, good Anush. NAFL has a very different set of syllabus. Still you are in the list, in top few. It's good. Which statement comparing the properties of electron, neutron and proton are correct? Which statement comparing the properties of electron, neutron and proton are correct? Okay, so time's up?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the answer? Which statement comparing properties of electron? So neutron and proton, B is the answer. B is the answer. Now I want to ask you one simple question. All of you are saying B is the answer because neutron and proton both are heavier than electron. And one electron and neutron, only electron and neutron are charged? No. Electron and proton are charged. Neutron is neutral. Okay? Proton has. Now, I just want to ask you one question. What is the... RNR 9 student will not going to reply. Please, RNR 9, please don't reply this question. Okay. What is the ratio of mass of proton as to mass of electron? What is this ratio?
So 1/187.
It's not 1/1837. Students, you all are just mugging up the thing.
1:1837.
No.
So
what I want to tell in this question, mass of proton is almost 2000 times. Mass of proton is almost 2000 times more than mass of electron. So if I ask you relative mass, of neutron, proton and electron, no RNR student, no autonomous syllabus, the students have autonomous syllabus, please don't tell answer of them. What is the ratio of relative mass? What is the relative mass ratio? What should I write in this column? Just tell me answer of
zero.
Here zero.
So 1 AM.
Okay, anyone?
No?
Okay, see, proton and neutron mass are almost same. Proton and neutron has almost same mass. Okay? So if I put relative mass of proton as 1, what should I write in these two columns? Proton as relative, what should I write the mass of neutron?
So 1.
Very good. Neutron is also 1 because both are same. Now tell me what is the answer of this. What should I write in the same piece of electron?
1/837.
Okay, 1/837 is almost, I asked you relative mass. Can I write it's almost 0? Very small. So that's why sometimes we write it 1837 or we write it 0. That's why in any atomic mass, we always write mass of proton plus neutron, mass of P plus mass of N. We never consider mass of electron because we neglect the mass of electron due to this very high ratio. Is it clear to all of you? Many of you could have this doubt that why we neglect mass of electron. This is just to explain all the students other than RNR9. Because I taught this thing in RNR.
So we have learned this in the last year, sir.
Okay, yeah, we learned this in the last year. So why you were not able to answer this relative mass thing? You should have answered in 1 second only.
I told 1 and 0.
Okay, next question. Okay, now. An atomic structure of 4 particles are shown. These are the atomic structures. Which 2 particles are isotopes? Okay, those who have all... Okay, fine. First finish it, then I will discuss.
Sir, time's over, sir.
Okay, now see. This question is very easy. They have asked you the 2 particles are isotopes. Isotopes means same proton. Same proton. I told you there is a one thing. I told this to INR students, INR 9. Isotopes means same proton. You all know. Same proton. Okay? Isotone means same
neutron.
And the last is isobar. Isobar is.
Sir, you're stopping screen sharing all of a sudden.
Okay, 1 minute. Can't you see? I think it's for you only. Can you see my screen, all of you? I think most
yes,
of
sir, I can see you.
Okay. Isobar is same mass number. So these things you need to remember. Isotone means neutron same. Isotope P means proton same. Isobar means mass number same. Okay. So in this question they have asked you isotopes. So isotope means which are the two isotopes where the proton number are same. Proton number are same in this and this. So answer is W and Y. This question is very easy. But why I added this question to tell you the isotone and isobar also. Can you tell me what are among these having a are isotones? What among these are isotones? Write it. Isotones.
Y and Z.
Only one combination?
W, X, Y, Z.
Y and Z and W and X. These are isotones. Now last question. What are iso... Please mute your mic, Siddharth. Isobar. What all combinations are there for isobars?
There's no isobar here.
No isobar, sure? Anyone who got isobar?
Yes sir, there are no isobars.
No isobar. Total is 19, 10 plus 9, 19. Here it is 18. Here it is 16. Here it is 17. No isobars. Okay, is it clear to all of you? Yes? Could I move to next? Okay. Next question. Students, in this question, if you are making mistake, it's very disappointing, it's very bad actually. You should answer it properly by seeing the proton numbers. But those who have made mistake, I want to just clarify that whether you understood or not. There is no problem if you make mistakes. But if you have understood or not, that's a very important thing. Okay, next question. This is the question. I will read the question. Two atoms X and Y can be represented as shown. What is X 41, Y 45? They are on the top of the X and Y. And at bottom, it's 20 and 20. Which statement is not correct? X and Y are atoms of different elements. X and Y are isotopes. X and Y have different mass numbers. X and Y has same number of electrons. You have 30 seconds to answer.
So time over.
Okay. X and Y can be represented. They have asked not correct.
Answer is A.
Okay. So X is 41 and 45. These are the mass number. 20 and 20 are the atomic number. So X and Y are atoms of different element. No, that is wrong. They are same element because atomic number are same. X and Y are isotopes. Isotopes are only when they have the same mass number. Their mass number are different. So they are not... 1 minute. Are the isotopes? Are they isotopes? Same proton number.
Yes, so they are isotopes.
They are isotopes. X and Y have different mass number. Yes. X and Y have the same number of electrons. Yes.
Yes,
so
protons are same. Electrons has to be same.
Answer is A. Let us see how many of you got this question. Oh my God. Students, tell me where you are facing issue. This is the repetitive. I am repetitively.
So time was really less.
I didn't say the not.
What you are saying, Monisha?
So like by the time we saw the question on your screen and read it, the time was almost over.
Okay, I kept it 30 seconds. I thought it's a very easy question. That's why I kept it 30. Okay.
So next time, you can rather than like, so can you make it like bigger to see so, because it's very difficult, or you can integrate the question into Menti by typing the question out.
Okay, fine. See, next, okay, I'll do that from next time. Now, next question is, I'll keep the timing little more, because it seems like many of you have answered without reading the questions also. Okay, fine. We are moving to the next one. This is the next question. Two atoms have same relative atomic mass, but different chemical properties. You have 60 seconds for this. Two atoms have same relative atomic mass but different chemical properties. Which two atoms of proton neutron number of these two atoms is correct? Proton number, neutron number. Okay. Fine. So we'll see the fine. Only few students have answered it A. Maybe the answer is wrong. We'll see. 1 minute.
So it's B.
Has to be B.
No problem. So it has to be B.
That's what I thought. Okay, wait. Two atoms have a same relative atomic mass. Relative atomic mass is same, but different chemical properties. So these are isobars. Same relative atomic mass, but different chemical properties. Which row about the proton and neutron number of these atoms are correct?
So B.
Protons are different. Neutrons are different. So if protons are different, neutrons must be different, then only it will be isobars. Are you getting what I'm saying?
So, but it's not isobar. How is it given as isobar?
Fine.
So, one second. So, it says that the relative mass is same. That means one component has to be same, and that has to be the neutron.
Again, you are not understanding.
But mass number is equal to proton number. Neutron number is same, and it will be isotone.
Nucleon is neutron plus proton. Okay, this is, let's say, what happened? 1 minute, Monisha, we can't hear you.
No, I'll just type it out.
Okay, nucleon number is neutron plus proton. And I'm saying that nucleon number are same. Nucleon number are same means the sum is same. If sum is same, and you know that isobars are always the different elements, they can't be the same element. Isobars can't be the same element, means proton number must be different. If proton number must be different, if I'm saying that sum is equal to 15, let's say, if I want sum is equal to 15, okay, and the proton number is, one is the 4, and the other one is 4, so the neutron number must be equal 11 and 11. But I said that for the isobars, proton number must be different. Two elements must be different elements to be called as isobars, because they have the same nucleon number. So if they are the same, they have a different proton number, means one term is definitely different. If one term is different, the second has to be different. Is it clear? You can't have 15, if you want to get sum equals to 15 and one term is different, then second term must be different. Anyone has any doubt? The sum of neutron proton has to be same. So if proton is different, then neutron can't be same. Okay, Monisha, I thought you have doubt, but you have written the same thing what I am saying. Okay, any other doubt, students? Students, so you have any other?
Answer is A,
my dear. Why you are asking this? This means that you didn't understand the question. Student, please ask me, because these type of question I will not take again in the center bar.
So can you repeat?
Okay, see. Atomic mass is same. Atomic mass is same means isobar. Isobar means same mass number. Or mass is nothing but nucleon numbers. Nucleon. So if I say nucleons are same, that is proton plus neutron. Nucleons are same means proton plus neutron are same. So this sum is same. And if this sum is same for two elements X and Y, means if any of this changes, okay, if any of this changes, if I'll write it's a proton number, proton for X, neutron for X. Here I'll write proton for Y plus neutron for Y. I know that proton are definitely different. Protons are nothing but atomic number. Atomic number. I'll give you just an example. You know, the phosphorus is 31. Phosphorus mass is 31. Oh, sorry, 32. And what is the mass of sulfur? What is mass of sulfur? That is also 32. Okay? So both are having same mass number, but they can't be the same atomic number. They can't be the same atom. So proton number must be different. If proton number must be different, neutron must be different to balance and give the same nucleon number. So here the phosphorus has 15 atomic number, sulfur has 16 atomic number, but sulfur has 16 neutron, phosphorus has 17 neutron. So you can't have the same proton and neutron at all if the mass number is same. Am I clear? This is an example in front of you. Is it clear to all of you? First tell me yes or no. Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
So, fine. I think this question will change the result. We'll see. Only 8 students have answered it right. Good. Who all 8? Please tell, I will see in the result. Who 8 students have answered
right? Sir, it's the 15th question. You have to delete the 7th question now.
Very good, Monisha. Very good, Gandhar, Karun. Okay, fine. We have to change the 16th question. That was the 7th question. Yes?
So there's a question. There's only one more question.
Okay, one more question, then we'll finish and we'll see the result at the end. No worry. You can always see the result. Okay, last question. Table shows the particle present in the nuclei of 4 atoms or ions. Okay, please, one minute. I'll move. Okay, the B option is 1 and 4. B option, if someone has any doubt, 1 and 4. 1 and 4. B is 1 and 4. Okay, fine. So, please let me know once the time is over.
So, time's up.
Okay, fine. So, table shows the number of particles present in the nuclei of 4 atoms. 288, 288, 281, 282. The particle belongs to same element. Now, they have given atoms or ions. Okay? So, if the same element with proton number same, that's for sure. So, same proton number is for these 3 atoms. These 3 atoms have same proton number. So if you see, answer is 1 and 2. That's the best answer. 2 and 3. Okay, 1 minute. If you see the configuration, 2, 8, 2, 8, 2, 8, 1. Tell me what is the answer. Here.
So 1 and 2. So I marked it, but it was wrong ones.
Particles belongs to same element. So 2 and 3 are the same element. Please mute your Aditya. So if you see, this is nothing but potassium. 2, 8, 8, 1. And this is nothing but K plus ion. This is nothing but K plus ion. This 2, 8, 8 is nothing but argon. 2, 8, 8, 1 is argon. Okay. Now, this is calcium. So, answer will be 2 and 3. answer is 2 and 3. You need to go like this. Okay. Yes, answer is C. Because this is potassium, this is calcium. Potassium. Okay. Fine. So we'll see the result now. Answer is C. Okay. Now I'm going to change the answers. Just give me 1 second. Just tell me which was that question.
So question 7.
Okay, 1 minute. Let me change that question number 7th answer. Okay, what was the answer?
Don't remember.
Okay, fine, I'll check. 1 minute. Question number 7. 1 minute.
So how did you get C for the last one? So the question is wrong.
Okay, 1 minute. Question number 7.
So
yes, yes, tell me.
Question was wrong, sir.
Yes, so you
Okay, proton particles belongs to the same elements. Protons number, yes, last question is somewhere, it's like proton number, if you have gone with a proton number, it is also wrong. So I will consider A and D are the, A and C as the answers. In last question, I will mark A and C, both are correct. Okay?
No,
D is not there. 2 and 4 can't be because protons are different. 1 and 2. So answer is A and C for 16th question. 16th question A and C. I am marking it A and C, don't worry. A and C is the answer for 16th one. And for the 7th one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For 7th question, you are saying answer is C, yes?
No, so delete the
question.
Sir, delete.
Deleting the, okay, fine. So I'll delete the.
So just question. Delete both of them, sir.
So what do you do?
So delete 7 only.
Okay, just a minute.
So better to delete both.
Okay, one minute, students. Could you help me in deleting? I have not deleted any question so far. One minute. So here, option is, I'm sharing my screen. Fine. Yes. Where is the option of deleting the question?
Sir, you can go to the side and delete it.
Okay. Otherwise.
Sir, just hover on.
Okay.
So you have to go there. And
okay. I deleted that question. Fine.
So you have to delete the leaderboard also.
Okay. Fine. I'm deleting the leaderboard. Fine.
Thank you. The 7th question.
Yes, and 7th only. And the last question is this. Here also, it's a option. Okay, I'll delete this.
So why? So you don't need to delete. You can just change.
I don't need to delete the question. So it's correct.
So you can delete the options.
Okay. 1 minute. Fine. We'll keep the leaderboard. Okay. Fine. Now I'm going to the leaderboard. So your presentation.
Then the last one is not marked properly.
But if you see the option, only 2 options seem correct. If you go with the options. Okay, 1 minute. If you go with the options, only 2 options are correct. Now I'm going to the. I'll announce the result. A and D means there were 2 options, A and C, whatever. Okay, fine. So now I'm going to show you the result. Just a minute.
So you can actually go to Menti and start from the last question.
What? Okay, Menti and start from the last question only. There is one more thing.
So just keep spamming it so you'll reach.
Yes. I'm doing that only. 1 minute. Okay, so this is the last
question.
So you deleted slide as in leaderboard slide.
Okay, fine. So here, the last slide I'm deleting.
Sir, it's okay, sir. No point, sir.
Okay, I'll do it. One minute. This is the last slide. One minute. not cutting the minor pardon?
So quiz is not open.
One minute. I think Anuya is the winner only. Okay, so I think the last question is not going away. I don't know why it's not going. Just a minute, I'm going to the last slide. Okay, we'll see the last result, don't worry. We'll see the last result. Anuya is leading for this question also. Anuya, Anush, now next question is. Okay, this is the next. Okay, here it stops. So Anuya is the winner for the previous question. If you see, Anuya is leading and Srijan Ghosh is the second one. So, last question I have deleted. If you don't consider last question, Anuya and Gurgi are the winner. Fine. You got the result. Hey, congratulations, Anuya.
It's pronounced Gargi, not Gurgi.
Okay, Gargi. Sorry, Gargi.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Anuya. Nishant, you have also played well. Okay. Thank you, students. What happened?
So you have disabled sharing on your this thing, so you don't have to share the video on the desktop. Like,
one minute. After the Monisha, your voice is breaking too much. I can't hear you at all. No. Anuya, sorry. Monisha? Monisha, please type the message if you want to say something. Okay, so winner is Anuya. Very good.